Pope Francis made a historic appearance at the G7 summit held in Italy to address the pros and cons of artificial intelligence. This marked a significant moment as the Pope, at 87 years old and arriving in a wheelchair, was warmly greeted by leaders, including US President Joe Biden and Argentine President Javier Milei. He highlighted the dual nature of AI, noting its potential to inspire excitement and broaden access to knowledge, while also warning about the risk of increasing injustice between advanced and developing nations and between dominant and oppressed social classes. Italian Prime Minister Giorgia Meloni, who hosted the summit, emphasized that the G7 is not an exclusive club and should not be seen as the West against the rest. This inclusive approach was underscored by the presence of other heads of state and government, including the Prime Minister of India and President of Turkey. The core G7 members, comprising the United States, Britain, France, Germany, Japan, and Canada, focused heavily on China's economic practices. They expressed concerns about what they perceive as unbalanced markets in sectors such as electric vehicles, steel, and renewable energy. In a draft summit statement, they clarified that their intention is not to harm China, but to protect their businesses from unfair practices and to level the playing field. Additionally, the G7 leaders warned of potential actions against Chinese financial institutions that aid Russia in obtaining weapons for its war against Ukraine. This follows the US imposing fresh sanctions on China-based firms supplying semiconductors to Russia, amidst concerns over China's stance on Taiwan and maritime disputes with the Philippines. On the first day of the summit, the G7 nations agreed on a deal to provide $50 billion in loans for Ukraine, backed by interest from frozen Russian assets. This agreement was presented as a strong signal of Western resolve. The leaders also promised further sanctions against entities helping Russia circumvent restrictions on its oil trading. However, the summit was not without controversy. Italian Prime Minister Meloni faced challenges over sensitive social issues in the G7's final statement. There was no direct reference to abortion, despite pressure from France, and accusations arose of watering down support for LGBTQ rights compared to the previous G7 meeting in Japan. Italy defended its stance, arguing that there had been no change in the G7's position on these issues. Immigration was another key topic, particularly for Meloni, who is pushing for European support to curb illegal flows from Africa. She has launched a flagship plan to boost development in Africa to tackle the root causes of migration. As the summit draws to a close, many leaders, including President Biden, are set to leave Italy. Prime Minister Meloni has announced that the summit's conclusions have already been agreed upon, with a final press conference scheduled to wrap up the event. These discussions at the G7 summit highlight the complexities of global politics and the ongoing efforts to address economic, social, and geopolitical challenges.